theoretical and practical researchers, both on sound and on the implications of the pieces that I was making. Also, the fact that both pieces are presented in the same space and creating a dialogue. I believe that the main concern of these pieces is the dialogue I established between matter or sculpture and sound being the main vehicle to express or pass a narrative. So I guess in this perspective they encompass a lot of research on this, on both fields. It's interesting because, for example, one of the first authors I've been researching on was Georges Perec, which is a French writer. And I've been looking into this perspective of the infranormal, which is a translation of a French word. And my work encompasses that, that particular view of the world that resides exactly on that particular threshold that we almost never pay attention to. And so you can see here the dead flies and the insects and all of those instances, even sounds that we take for granted are the very basis of the of my works. I work on that realm of the infranormal, the glitches on the everyday life that trigger my research. So I think the work, yes, it does have a narrative. There are several layers of reading. It starts on the title of the work. It's called Threnody, and Threnody means a poem or a song written in memory of the dead. If my translation is not correct, it's not mistaken. This work has to do exactly with that circularity of life and at the time span of things. So this work has been filmed in a slow motion. It's presented as a slow motion video, and for that I stretched the time. Also, the sound is stretched. There is this circular and counter-circular movements within the mechanism itself. So within these different mechanisms, there are different velocities, different temporalities. Also, the fact that the music box itself was already in the original object tampered with. The sound is also tampered with, so also stretching it again, it's another layer of...
But to stretch it directly via the computer or via the mechanics of the,
no,
of the machine?
No, I tampered with it via the mechanics of the actual music box, so you cannot hear a particular tune. And then when you film it and you record it, and then stretch it or make it into a slow motion video, and slow motion the sound is also stretched.
Yeah.
And that is the exact measure that the video is stretched to the point or to the same percentage of the sound. And that was one of the first findings when I was investigating and researching on this matter. Since I've entered the master of artistic research, I've been asked to have a retrospective look into my practice. And in that moment, I realized that there is an ongoing discourse with these pieces, with the glasses and the bell jars, as you said. I started working with them exactly because they have this quality of protecting something, this object that lets you perceive what it contains, but it won't allow you to touch it. So it's intangible, yet it's tangible because it's there right in front of you. The other part of the answer to your question is that I do not perceive that the visual work or the sculptural work is disconnected by the other existences or unfoldings that the projects may have. This is one of the hints or one of the paths that my research is aiming for. Is exactly that. Is it a performance? Is it a sound installation? Is it a crystallization of a composition? Maybe all those existences may be explored in one project. So the unfoldings of one concept can be several. So in this sense, first, I started with this project in dialogue with a previous project I have. It's called Lament, and it's also a sculptural piece, but one that also can be used as a sound installation and an instrument almost. And this is a second step on this research. Which is to understand how can I reframe my understanding of these unfoldings of projects and concepts into my practice. I've discovered also that I work in cycles of disappointment, anguish, and escape, which is a cycle that I perceive in all my practice since I've graduated till today, which is almost quite some time. And this particular piece is exactly on the anguish state of this cycle. And the sounds that you can create with these objects have a dialogue with also these other piece, the Threnody. And so it made sense to present it here and create a dialogue, an ongoing dialogue within the exhibition, and also to activate it by the performance and to experiment in that sense, to take this opportunity to be in the MAR and within the final exhibition of the first year to experiment further on that. How do we present an ongoing project and activate it into different existences?